Let's stop this. Stop fighting. It's a waste of human life. We've achieved our objective. We've broken the pirates' power, so why are we chasing them? The soldiers who die from here on are... They're fools who will die for nothing. Hello and welcome to One Piece 101, the series that breaks down everyone and everything in the One Piece world. Today, we are going to be examining the marine prodigy, Coby. Coby is an enthusiastic and justice-driven young boy whose dream is to become a marine admiral. He's an often forgotten about character and mainly exists in the background of the series, which is pretty crazy because Coby is exceptionally important and was actually the very first person Luffy befriended on his journey. At the time, Coby was serving as an involuntary cabin boy for the Alvida Pirates. And involuntary is probably a bit of an understatement, actually. Coby was essentially enslaved, and so afraid of Captain Alvida that he had lost any semblance of hope, and even given up on his initial dream of becoming a marine. So Coby was very much the opposite of Luffy in these early days. In fact, Coby's timid and submissive nature even prompted Luffy to say that he hated him, although he did so with a smile. As a result, Coby very much served as the audience perspective for Luffy's first couple of short adventures. Although as a result of meeting Luffy, Coby was finally able to stand up to Captain Alvida, calling her a smelly, fat, old hag. This of course left Alvida absolutely livid, but it didn't matter because Luffy proceeded to defeat her with a single blow. From here, Coby told Luffy about a pirate hunter by the name of Roanoa Zoro, who happened to be captured by the Marines. Coby then lent his navigational ability to Luffy and the two sailed to Shell's Island so that Luffy could meet and recruit Zoro. Of course, it wasn't that straightforward, as Luffy, Coby, and Zoro ended up in an altercation with Captain Morgan, the ranking officer in command of the Shell's Town base. At one point, Coby was even held hostage by Morgan's son, Helmeppo. But just like Alvida, Morgan was also fairly swiftly defeated, much to the delight of the Marines under his command. Following this, Coby took a huge step forward in his life and decided to pursue his dream by enlisting in the Marines right then and there. As Luffy and Zoro sailed away from the island, Coby and the rest of the Marines offered them a salute, signaling respect and gratitude for the duo. However, as a result of saluting pirates, they were all punished by having to undergo a week without food. And just like that, Coby faded into the background of the story to proceed with his own journey. His next appearance would be during a cover story which details Coby's early marine life with Helmeppo, who had no real choice but to join the Marines after his father was imprisoned. And oddly enough, Coby and Helmeppo actually became very good friends over time, and the two Marines eventually caught the eye of Vice Admiral Garp. Garp ended up taking Coby and Helmeppo to Marineford to put them through some fairly brutal training, and rather surprisingly, the two boys absolutely excelled and showed a huge amount of potential for the future. Speaking of the future, we are going to have to jump all the way to the end of the Enies Lobby arc for the next time Coby appears in the series. Following the Straw Hat's invasion and victory over the Judicial Island, Coby accompanied Garp to the shipbuilding island of Water 7 to pay Luffy a visit. Instead of a standard hello, Coby simply attacked Luffy out of nowhere with Soru, one of the Rokushiki techniques. This showed that Coby had grown an exceptional amount since his last appearance, although he was still no match for Luffy and rather easily beaten. Now this point in the story is where Coby's appearance changed so rapidly that he now looks like an entirely different character. Oda's explanation for this is that Coby underwent a growth spurt as well as tightened his muscles due to Garp's intensive training. During their reunion, Coby accidentally blurted out his dream of becoming a Marine Admiral. Luffy immediately accepted this as a foregone conclusion and responded by saying that if Coby wants to fight with Luffy in the New World, then he could not be anything less than an Admiral. And even Zoro recognized Coby's newfound strength and commented to Luffy that he had just created another great enemy in the world. And this great enemy would show up once more during the Paramount War. Along with the entirety of the Marine organization, Coby was summoned to participate in the Battle of Marineford against the Yonko Whitebeard. Although Coby and Helmeppo very quickly realized just how out of their league they were and chose to run away. However, before they could complete their dash to freedom, they stumbled upon Marine Admiral Akainu, punishing another Marine for desertion. And when I say punished, I mean Akainu brutally killed him. So this was more than enough incentive for Coby to return to his post. Soon after this, Monkey D. Luffy arrived at Marineford with his jailbreak squad from Impel Down in order to save his brother Ace from execution, which was the intended action that incentivized the entire war. Upon seeing Luffy, Coby resolved to fight so that he could grow and change on the battlefield, telling himself that he needed to combat Luffy as if he wanted to kill him. Unfortunately, Luffy then proceeded to defeat Coby with a single punch, leaving him unconscious on the battlefield. By the time Coby regained consciousness, both Porkass D. Ace and Whitebeard had been killed, meaning that the Marines had achieved their objective. However, the battle continued to rage to new extremes. It was in this moment that Coby seemed to awaken an incredible sense of observation haki, as he was able to sense people's voices disappearing around him, indicating that they were dying. This level of observation haki is so advanced that it can be compared to Aisa and Anel's abilities during the Skypiea arc. And in a moment that can only be described as incredibly brave and possibly idiotic, Coby blocked the path of Marine Admiral Akainu, who was about to kill Luffy, and proceeded to yell out so loudly that the entire battlefield came to a standstill. "Let's stop this. Stop fighting. It's a waste of human life. We've achieved our objective. We've broken the pirates' power. So why are we chasing them? It's not necessary. This is pure bloodlust. Some of the wounded can still be saved if they're treated right away. But we're consigning them to death and creating more casualties. The soldiers who die from here on, they're just, they're fools who will die for nothing." Akainu then moved to kill Coby for wasting valuable seconds of battle. Coby was terrified but held his ground and prepared to die, harboring no regrets. However, at that exact moment, another Yonko, Red Hair Shanks, arrived at Marineford and blocked Akainu's magma fist aimed at Coby. Coby, now sandwiched between two of the world's greatest powers, fell unconscious immediately. And while Coby didn't hear this, Shanks praised the young Marine for his few seconds of courage and claimed that they would go on to profoundly shape the world, because in essence, Coby had saved Luffy's life. Coby would then wake up in a Marine healing center, clearly traumatized by his intense experience of observation haki. Some more fun facts about Coby. Despite not having appeared again in the manga since the Battle of Marineford, Coby has appeared in other media, specifically One Piece Film Z, which revealed his post-time skip design, as well as his promotion to the rank of captain. Furthermore, in Volume 1000, a special release for attendees of Film Z, Oda confirmed that Coby's observation haki had grown considerably during the 2-year time skip. Coby also appears in all of his post-time skip glory during the episode of Luffy television special, having become significantly stronger and apparently having mastered other Rokushiki techniques. However, this special is not canon, so I wouldn't be too quick to use this as an example of Coby's post-time skip strength. As a Marine, Coby holds the fastest known promotion through ranks, going from an enlisted man to captain in just 2 years. He is also presumably the youngest captain in the Marines, sitting at a mere 17 years old after the time skip. And finally, a truly useless fact. Despite apparently no longer needing to use glasses, Coby still wears them on his head. And that pretty much does it for Coby. If you enjoyed this video, then feel free to like, favorite, or subscribe, and please do comment with who, what, or where you'd like to see featured in the next One Piece 101.